I'm Ayla. I work in the Make Your Mark Gallery at the Louisiana Children's Museum. I love making music. You'll often find me playing all kinds of instruments at the Jammin' House at the museum. Thanks for joining me today for Connections at Home. Today, we're going to experiment with making sound and music by reusing objects you find in your home. It's going to be really fun.
One of the museum's core values is all about our dynamic community and creating experiences that highlight our own local culture. One famous part of our local culture is music. Music can make us feel different emotions, it can help us express ourselves, and it brings our community together in celebration.
Today, we're going to learn how to repurpose everyday items to make instrument inventions. As we make our homemade instruments, let's think about this question. How can we experiment with the objects around us to create sound? Start by gathering different materials around your house you think could be used to make cool sounds. I looked around and I found a couple forks, some cardstock, dry rice, chopsticks, wax paper, rubber bands, plastic containers, beads, a paper towel, and toilet paper rolls. And an old retainer, because why not? Once you've gathered a few materials, try experimenting with the different sounds you can create. How would you create a loud or a soft sound, or a high or low pitch? Or how about a smooth or scratchy sound? How would you describe the sound that these two forks make when I tap them together? Versus the sound they make when I tap them on the plastic container or the retainer. Remember, as the instrument inventor, it's up to you to decide what types of sound you want to make.
Maybe you'd like to create a percussion or rhythmic instrument out of some dry beans or rice, or some old Mardi Gras beads you still have flying around. A percussion instrument keeps the time in a piece of music. Or maybe you prefer a string instrument. Rubber bands are great for making string instruments because you can adjust the pitch. You can make it higher by tightening the rubber band, or lower by loosening the rubber band. And you can play a song. As long as your grown-up says it's okay, you can use anything you find to create a brand new instrument.
Now that I've experimented with different materials around my house, I'm gonna use some of them to make a kazoo. A kazoo is an instrument that manipulates the sound of your voice by giving it a buzzing quality, kind of like a bee.
To make your kazoo, all you need is a small piece of wax paper or plastic bag, a toilet paper roll or a piece of cardstock taped into a cylinder shape, and a rubber band. First, ask an adult to help you poke a small hole into the side of your toilet paper roll. Then take your wax paper and wrap it tightly around one end of your toilet paper roll. Then take your rubber band and secure the wax paper in place.
Now I'm ready to decorate. Once you've finished decorating, your kazoo is ready to play. Let's test it out. A kazoo is a wind instrument, which means that the sound is produced by the vibration of air through the instrument. A vibration is something that moves back and forth. When you sing into your kazoo, your voice travels through the tube and makes the wax paper vibrate. If you press your finger lightly to the wax paper when you sing into the kazoo, you can feel that vibration. Now it's your turn. You can like I did, or you can invent a brand new instrument. While you're inventing, think about the different moods you can create with your music. Can you make a relaxing song or an upbeat song? Once your instruments are made, it's time to put on a concert and announce that you're about to perform. Come on, let's go gather up an audience.
Once you've finished building your instrument, you can put on a concert for your family, stuffed animals, pets, or your imaginary friend, Steve.
You can experiment with all kinds of objects in your home to make sounds. We'd love to see the instrument inventions and at-home concerts that you create. You can share with us on social media and tag us at #LouisianaKids and #LCMConnections. Thanks for joining me for Connections at Home. I'm Ayla, and I hope you'll join us for the next episode. Until then, let's play, learn, and stay connected.